you know, it's just one of those deals where, you know, I am who I am. I'm not going to grow anymore. I definitely will get stronger. But I just know I'm a basketball player and I'll fit in, you know, right when I step on the floor.
And at the combine in Chicago really proved that he's an NBA caliber athlete. I think people question his athleticism. There are no questions anymore.
Does McDermott get this wide open for the game-winning three-pointer?
Figured out with all that talent. Look out.
McDermott drains the triple.
Yeah, my dad was a lot harder on me than he was everyone else. I know that. He kind of let me know early on in the process that that's how it was going to be, or else it wouldn't have worked, you know. I think if he was playing favorite to me at all times, it would have looked bad, you know, in the locker room. And you know, it helped, you know, being one of the main guys on the team. He could get after me, and I knew it was no lost love. He was just trying to prove a point to the team and not just me, so.
Yeah, you know, it was very enjoyable when it was going on, but I think we've grown to appreciate it more as the years have gone by. Having the chance to be at every practice, you know, let alone his historic run and scoring all the points he did in college, to be part of that on a daily basis and watch his growth was really special for me. And then to continue to watch him in the NBA is, you know, it's still surreal to me every time I turn on a game or am fortunate enough to get to game. So I'm obviously very proud of what he did as a Blue Jay and what he continues to do in the NBA with San Antonio.
First off, just wanted to thank you guys for coming. After a lot of thought, talking to a lot of people, I decided it's best for me to come back for my senior year. So with that being said, you guys can ask me any questions. I'll be here to answer.
I think from the beginning, his heart was that he wanted to come back. And even though the facts probably pointed otherwise, I think at the end of the day, he went back to what his gut and what his heart was telling him, and that's that he wanted to remain at Creighton another year.
You get to come back for your family, play in front of friends, play with Grant Gibbs again. I mean, what a special night for this young man, and to set a career high 45 points on your senior night on your home floor. Nothing better than that. That's what makes college basketball so great.
It's unbelievable. You know, my senior year was so much fun because we had a couple guys get extra years of eligibility to come back as well, which made it that much sweeter. And we were moving into a new conference, into the Big East. We got to play in the Garden two or three times that year. You know, play Villanova at Nova, you know, just all these big time games, having Bill Raftery and Gus Johnson call your games, being featured on Sports Illustrated. I mean, it was just crazy. It was a whirlwind. And I remember talking to Kyle Korver before my senior year to decide if I should come back or not. And he played the league for what, 17 years, and he told me you can't put a price tag on another year of college, and that really stuck with me, and I'm so glad I came back.
With the 11th pick in the 2014 NBA draft, the Denver Nuggets select Doug McDermott from Creighton University.
Doug McDermott led the nation in scoring last year. He's the fifth leading scorer in the history of college basketball. How do you think he'll fare in the NBA?
I think he'll fare very well. I mean, he's the best and most versatile scorer in this draft.
He's the Bulls rookie, although drafted by Denver and then traded to the Bulls. He's Doug McDermott who joins us on the show. Hi, Doug.
How's it going?
Doing okay. Take me through draft night. When Denver is drafting you, what are you told at that time?
Well, I was actually pretty well aware that Chicago was trading up. My agent was sitting right at the table next to me. So when Denver called my name, I knew I probably wasn't going to end up there. So I threw on that Denver hat and, you know, walked across the stage, but knew I had a pretty good idea that I wasn't going there.
I think that's what it naturally evolved into, and it took some time. It took a lot of time because I basically was changing the way I play basketball in the highest league possible. So I knew there would be a lot of growing pains, and that's probably why I got traded for, you know, I was on four or five teams in like 6 years. And I think, I mean, it sucked. You know, there were moments I thought maybe this could be it, but, you know, Indiana, when I got to Indiana, just having some stability there for 3 years, playing for Coach Nate McMillan and then Nate Bjorkgren. They believed in me so much, and they gave me a ton of confidence, and that allowed me to get here with San Antonio. And I'm so grateful for that because this place is, it just feels like me.
Yeah. McDermott.
Oh, mama!
Porter. And nice start as Doug McDermott gets a dunk. And the Spurs pull with it.
Warren and Baylor knocks down a three. McDermott got that one again as McBuckets coming through. And the shooters are having a nice day.
I was nervous coming in playing for Pop. You know, I just didn't know what to expect. I expected him to be hard on his guys. And, you know, he is hard, but he's also just a great role model. You know, he's worried about things outside of basketball more than he is basketball. And I think that makes you play with some, just a little at ease, you know, knowing that, you know, it's just a game. It's our job. We need to play well, but there's so many things off the court that are more important in the grand scheme of things.
Well, from a coach's perspective, that's also his father, you know, to be able to play for Pop, you know, there's nothing more I could want for my son. You know, late in his career, as a young, when he, you know, now he really understands the game and understands the NBA, to be able to go somewhere where you can learn on another level from one of the best has been awesome for him and great for me because I pick his brain all the time about some of the things that Pop does and says. But it's been great for Doug. He loves playing for Pop, loves the way he relates to the players, and you know they both like wine, so they have that in common. So that's certainly a positive as well.
Well, you know, the very first thing that you could see is that his dad taught him how to move without the basketball. And he knows that's a smart thing to do because the more he moves and chases space, the more shots he gets. And he loves to shoot. So, and he's good at it. But his movement without the ball impressed me right off the bat.
McDermott, corner three. Yes, sir!
I knew that I'd have to step up my leadership role, but just leading by example, just trying to play the right way, and just helping your teammate up, helping your brother up, cheering for him, being a good guy in the locker room. These are all things that I've tried to do a better job of this year. We're gonna keep getting better. These guys are gonna be more prepared when there's more young guys that are gonna come into the mix, and you know, I think the future's extremely bright in San Antonio because we have that mindset. We're not hanging our heads. You know, we're pissed off when we lose, but we know that there's a bigger purpose here this year.
And actually, this will be the first time he's seen us play in 8 years. So it's good to have him here, and obviously our fans love Doug. For, you know, he stood for all the right things when he played for Creighton, and I'm glad it worked out that the Spurs are off tonight and he can come and enjoy a night in Texas with his family.
I love the Moody Center. I think they did a great job with that, and it just made me that much more excited to play there later on in April. Just going there, being in that great atmosphere, seeing a lot of Creighton fans, a lot of familiar faces. But just to be able to watch him and see him before the game, after, just seeing him in action, it was so cool. And just be there with my family, I hope I can do a lot more of it because I was more nervous on that in that arena watching him than I've been on the NBA court. So it's a very special feeling.